Hello, I figured I would get this review of the Golden Motor v.2 controller out of my hair. We'll start with the case. The case is nice. I give it a 9 out of 10. They could actually save even a little bit more money and kept the price down by making the top out of hard plastic, painting it, because there's no way the bottom's going to wick to the top for the heat. So that's a bit of overkill on the aluminum there. Could have saved money on that. The wiring, well, the wiring is, you know, it is what it is. It's Golden Motor wiring. It's always been cheap. Fray, crappy connectors. Like, over time, these will wiggle, and they'll lose connections, and you have all kinds of issues. I'll give them one. They've always been like that. The alarm. This thing is loud and annoying. If I was going to steal someone's e-bike, and I saw the strap to their bicycle, I would rip this off before I took the bike. So, the alarm is useless. Yeah. The actual controller itself failed even before I had a chance to mod it. Failed at 57 volts. If the controller didn't have a built-in alarm, it actually would be better for modding or overvolting. Anybody who is overvolting it, just the way it is, we'll find, even at 48 volts, this little transformer here, this is for your alarm speaker, that runs hot. Anything over 48 volts, it gets really hot, and over time that will cook itself to death. And when that shorts, it shorts the regulator, it shorts the other regulator, it's on the other side, and then you lose the 5 volts, or in my case what happened is that the 5 volts turned to 12, and it fried the main chip. Controller chip, so that makes this controller garbage. Still powers up, it just doesn't do anything. So, I mean, I know that's what people on other forums have been trying to do, is overclock it, overvolt it, and they've been running into the same problems. It turns on, it doesn't work. It just powers up, makes a spark, it just doesn't work. So, that's your weak point right there. It's the whole speaker setup, and the alarm is, yeah, it's garbage. Serviceability, I give it a 2 out of 10. The gates for the FETs, for servicing them, are actually right beside, if not right underneath the FET. So trying to fix those, and you have to keep bending this up and down to work on them, would be a pain in the butt. Other defects or design flaws that I see for longevity of this controller. They ran out of room. I'm going to show you with the loop here. They ran out of room, so what they did is they tied. Let's see if we can get one here. There's one. You see that little brown resistor there? They soldered those right to the legs of the FET, and over time, they'll drop their resistance or fail altogether. And basically probably blow a FET. So, and you can see the gates are right under the legs, you know, where the heat is. There's a brown one there. That's probably the only brown one there that's actually not right on the leg. So that's an issue with design. They ran out of room. So overall, yeah, I give the controller a 4 out of 10. For bicycles, it's all right. But where this controller would really shine is it's a good replacement for the scooter-style e-bikes. Because you can put this under the fairing. You can put the alarm underneath the fairing so no one can see it. And then all the features that you're paying for this would actually make more sense on a scooter-style e-bike, right? Overall, for bicycles, yeah, it's still, I'd say, 4 or 5 at the most. So, that's my review. Take it as you will. I had fun with it, and I didn't even get a chance to mod it.